we're going to introduce an important concept called resolved rate motion control. It sounds complex, but it's really quite simple to understand. For a lot of real-world problems, we might be interested in the robot end effector moving along a straight line in Cartesian space. Now, we know that if we move, for instance, joint angle 1, or we move joint angle 2, then the end of the robot tends to move in arcs in space. We don't want it to move in arcs, we want it to move along a straight line. So we're going to specify the Cartesian velocity that we want the end effector to follow. And we want to convert that then to the required joint velocity. We've already touched on this. We take the desired velocity, nu, we multiply it by the inverse Jacobian, and we get the joint velocity that we need. And we can compute this inverse Jacobian. We can write it out symbolically, as I have done here. Now what I need to do is to have the robot's hardware move the joints at this desired velocity. But after the robot's been moving for a short period, the joint angle vector Q will have changed, so the Jacobian that I computed will no longer be appropriate. So what I need to do then is periodically update the Jacobian matrix and use that when I'm computing the desired robot velocity vector Q dot. So it's a matter of moving the robot joints, updating the Jacobian, computing the robot joint velocity, moving the joints, updating the Jacobian, and so on. I repeat this indefinitely. Most control algorithms that run on a digital computer are typically discrete time algorithms. That is, they compute things at discrete time intervals. So here we have a timeline, and we've indicated a number of time steps. Time 1, time 2, time 3, and so on. And the duration of these time steps I'm going to denote by the symbol delta t. You know, it might be 1/10 of a second, it might be 1/1000 of a second, something like that. Now, at every time step, what I'm going to do is to take the current value of the joint angles, I'm going to call that qk, that stands for the joint angles at time k. I'm going to compute the Jacobian, take the inverse, multiply it by the velocity that I want to achieve, and compute the Q dot that I need to achieve at this particular time step. Now what I'm going to do is to take that joint velocity Q dot, I'm going to multiply it by delta t, so that will give me a joint angle displacement, that is, how much I want the joints to move over the coming time interval. I add that to the current value of the joint angles, QK, and that gives me the robot's target, that's where I want the robot joint angles to be at time K plus 1. Then I tell the robot hardware to move the joints to this new joint angle configuration over the time interval delta t. And then I repeat these steps for as long as necessary.